Welcome to Fresh Blood, where we hope that you are having a scary Halloween, filled with horror movies, sweets, junk food, a little bit, and maybe even a couple of scary stories that you're ready to tell. My name is Steve Hall, and I'm a filmmaker, and my favourite genre of movies to watch and to make are horror films. So you're here because you want to make a horror film. I've been making horror movies for years, and often on a very limited budget. Shoestring budget is what you'd say, but more like lucky to be able to pay our friends in pizza kind of budget. Most of the best horror films were made for next to nothing. But why are they the best? It's because they had to get creative with what they had available to them. But most importantly, they had to get inventive. They looked around them and saw what they had available to them, and then made a story incorporating those things to use the strengths of what they had. You'll see a lot of horror films usually have two things. They have some really good special effects, or they don't, and you know the ones. Or they have a really good location. And usually the location does most of the work. So these days, we're in lockdown, and we're restricted on our movements and our interactions, and it sucks. Right? Well, it doesn't have to, because just think about all these great horror films. This is our chance to get inventive and creative. So let's think about what we can do. So Fresh Film and I have curated some of the best horror film resources around the internet to help jumpstart your imagination stations and get those terror-filled nightmare fuel ideas flowing. So first up is one of my favorite horror shorts. It's called Lights Out. Let's have a watch. Now, how good was that? It's such a good horror short. It's so effective and so simple. Like, there's, what, two actors in it, props, maybe duct tape and a lamp. Like, there's nothing really to it. This is something that any of us could make, but it's such a unique take on something that all of us have experienced. We've all been a little bit afraid of the dark at some stage, and it's such a cool way to manifest that. Yes, there are some visual effects at the end, but I'm pretty confident that a good number of you watching could probably do a better job than they did in the film. But you know who you are, and anybody that wants to learn, I'll put a link in the description down below. So, another one of the reasons why this is one of my favorite horror shorts is because of the story that's attached to it. David F. Sandberg is the filmmaker, he's a filmmaker in Sweden, and he made this film for a horror film festival called Bloody Cuts. So yeah, this film didn't win at the film festival. But it went mega viral, and I mean went everywhere, so much so that all the film studios wanted to buy up the rights to actually make a feature version of the film. And they did. David had the pick of the crop, and he decided to go with Warner Brothers. Yeah, Warner Brothers, that's right, that Warner Brothers. And they turned it into a multi-million dollar horror film called Lights Out that David got to direct.
There's this woman waiting in the shadows.
I see her too.
One minute you're making a little horror film in your house for a little film festival, and then the next minute you're making it for Blumhouse and Warner Brothers. So that is a pretty big deal, and that is such a source of inspiration for me as a filmmaker, and I hope it is for you too, because that means that anybody can do it, and you don't have to have the most props, the biggest or the best location. He used what he had, and he made something incredible. So let's see how we can do that. Now that we're all juiced up and ready to go, let's look at some of the options that we have as filmmakers. So I'm pretty sure that most of us have some of these things in some kind of a way. Maybe a garden, a house, apartment, bedroom, garage, whatever you can think that you could maybe just turn the perspective of it and make it a little bit scary. This can be done with lighting. Maybe that's a case of that you're switching off a light like this. So this office isn't a scary office, but it's all about starting to tweak your location and making things happen that make it scary. Even just a small little change. Location-based horror is one of the biggest and best genres of horror because it gives you scope and the ability to place yourself in that situation as a viewer going, what would I do if I was there? What would I do in that situation? And that's where you can feel real fear, because it's about you. It's not about some abstract character or about a guy in a hockey mask. But speaking of masks, masks are a pretty big thing right now because everybody has to wear them wherever we go. So wouldn't it be cool to kind of use that and think, what can I do with a mask? So next up, we have a video from a really, really great channel called Film Riot that shows us how to tweak a cheap mask from a Halloween shop and start to make it something scary. So think about their lighting here. They didn't make things really super bright, they kept it dark and scary. But we can do that in our house. Leave the light on in one of the rooms, turn the lights off everywhere else, and let the light from that room bleed out and hit the back of someone's head, causing them to be in shadow, something like a silhouette, something like this. But the reason why this is one of the best filmmaking channels on YouTube is because they actually show you how they made this horror short.
These pop-up Halloween stores are the best thing about this time of year. It's basically a prop store, and if you wait until after Halloween, everything goes on sale, so you can get props, blood, and makeup for even cheaper. But we walked through the store looking for something that popped out at us and finally found this mask. Pretty great looking off the bat and only $37, so we grabbed it, knowing we could make it look even better with lighting and a few other tricks. Next is how we lit it, and it's horror, so of course we're gonna light it dark, which is gonna help us out a lot. The more contrasty and dark you can get with a mask, mask like this, the more it's gonna work on camera. But the final thing we did while shooting was to wet the mask. I wanted it to have an off-putting, dripping look to it, but I would have given it that wet look either way to try to keep it from looking rubbery. So I took a spray bottle, filled it with water and baby oil, which is exactly how we handle it when we want an actor to look sweaty on camera as well. Then we soaked it down between takes. Now we have this great glistening and interaction with the mask. I also considered coating it in Vaseline and adding blood around the mouth and other areas, but that didn't end up being the look that I wanted. It would be a great way to give more life and believability to a mask like this though. So we have a great look going right in camera, and if you shoot it right, this works as is, but we took it even further with some work on it in post.
So there's plenty more there, so I'm gonna leave that link down in the description down below. So now we're gonna watch a horror short that was in the Fresh Film Festival, and we even have a special message from the filmmaker himself.
Hey guys, how are you? My name is Sean. I hope you're all well and I hope you're all staying safe. I'm here to talk to you a little bit about making some short films, if you're thinking about it, which you should definitely do. Cool, so a little bit about myself. I've been interested in film my whole life. When I was 17 years old, I discovered Fresh Film Festival and I entered and I won an award for directing. So the following year I entered again and I actually won that year, which was pretty cool. It was very cool. So if you're thinking about making some films, be sure to go with Fresh. Some things that I learned from making these two films, which I think could be useful advice for yourselves, is number one, you don't need 20 different locations to make a really good movie. The film that I won with was all set in my house. The story was set in one night. Sometimes less can be more, pretty much. So what you should do, what you could do is, which is very, very useful, if you walk around your house into every single room with your camera and you record every corner, every nook and cranny, every single wall, you'll be surprised how many different locations you can make in one house. I spent about 2 hours one night, I was by myself with my camera, just wandering my house, seeing what looked well, what looked good. And yeah, I came up with some nice angles, some nice shots. Everything looked different, but it was all in the one location. Number two, some advice. Something very, very important and to take into consideration. If you are choosing to shoot in one location, one house, I would recommend try and set your story at nighttime. Because if you set in the daytime and you film a couple of scenes at about 2 p.m. and then you have to go and do one more later on, so you film at 6 p.m., the light is going to look completely different and the continuity might not be that smooth. However, if you set at night, you have full control of the light, so it looks more fluid and better. That's my advice. Secondly, again, this goes with the light as well. What you could do, which what I did, and it worked very, very well, is find all the lamps in your house, find all the torches you have, any different kind of lights that you can move around. You don't have to buy any, just use what you have in your house. You can go into every room. If you place them in all different areas of the room, each room can look completely different depending on one lamp. If you tilt the lamp, take off the shade or put on the shade or put a blanket over a lamp, but just be careful. You'd be surprised at how much creative control you can have in your house. If you don't have that many people, that's okay. My film was just one character walking around your house. So just think, the character doesn't even need to speak. It doesn't need to be a very, very good actor or actress. But just make sure if they're not speaking that they're doing something. So rather than thinking, they're actually doing an action. So they can be very simple actions. My character was dialing the phone, walking on the stairs. But if they're doing something, then a story can be interesting. You don't need to have so many lines or so much dialogue or big performances. That's not necessary for a good movie. I hope that helps, and go make some movies, guys.
When you're thinking about your horror film, it doesn't need to be really long. It could be just based on the scare. Some of the best horror shorts just land you in the thick of it and allow you to feel the fear straight away. One of the best examples of this is from the filmmaker Danny Donahue on YouTube. He's made a series of super creepy shorts, and one of them is the 17-second horror film that you've got to see. So that's such a cool, like, really short film, but it's so effective. And what makes it even cooler is when you find out how they did that big, giant, scary thing. It's just so easy. So Danny has explained it on his YouTube channel. So here, let's just go over to Danny.
Hi, I'm Danny Donahue, and right now I'm going to quickly tell you about some low-budget creature effects, if you want to even call them that, that I made for a recent short film of mine called Stay Dead.
Stay Dead.
It It's a 17-second short film, and I came up with the idea the day before we shot, so I didn't really have a whole lot of time to come up with a design for the creature and didn't really have any resources or money to spend on it. So came up with this guy, which is essentially me thinking, what is the simplest costume I can make out of household items, which is a bedsheet over the head to make a ghost. And then I was thinking, how can I modify that to make it a little creepier, make it a little different? I wanted to make it taller so that it would stretch up and almost touch the top of the door frame. So to do that, I wouldn't be able to have somebody actually wear it. Rather, we made a puppet out of it of sorts. So it's just mounted on a dowel. It's painted green because we used it for some green screen stuff in the past. But basically the shoulders are just this coat hanger that I duct taped across it. And the head is some foam, like mattress foam. Then I used a plastic skull mask from a Halloween store and mounted that on the front of the foam head and then draped the sheet over it.
So now that we've got our location, we've got our idea, and we've roped in whoever we're in lockdown with, friends, family, dogs, cats, it doesn't matter. Let's think about how we plan this out. One of the best ways to do that is to create a storyboard, which one of our fresh filmmakers happened to have done for a short that they're getting ready to film. Storyboards are a brilliant idea because it helps you visualize what's in your head and also helps you show other people what you want to create. I've really enjoyed putting this together with Fresh, and I hope you can see that the only limitation is your own imagination. So go out there, dream big, and tell scary stories. And make sure you check the description down below, because I'm going to be putting links to all the content that was here and behind the scenes on how they made them. So stay safe, stay scary, and make films.